for the first one, I couldn't find anything local, and I really wanted to get the vaccination as soon as I could.
Quest Yarborough got his second Pfizer shot at Lumen Field, but 3 weeks ago, he took a drive.
We went to Yakima.
And his car could have been one of these dots, showing people driving from the Seattle metro area to the Sundome in Yakima to a mass vaccination site with appointments.
Guys see dots that are in different colors. What is that telling you?
What that tells us is an approximate kind of zone where people are coming from. And so from that, we can look, okay, we see some heading up to Yakima from Boise.
Bob Pishu is an engineer with Kirkland-based INRIX. INRIX tracks traffic and things like commute times around the world. But Pishu wondered if traffic data could tell him something about how far we're willing to go for a vaccine.
So I just wanted to get an idea of the landscape.
And on INRIX's website, he blogged about it. He looked at people driving to mass vaccination sites at the Arlington Airport in Snohomish County and even a Lumen Field itself.
What does this graphic tell you?
Yeah, so that was the graphic from trip distance to Lumen Field. So more people closer to Lumen Field are making a shorter trip.
Meaning fewer people are having to drive long distances to get their vaccination.
How do you know that? I mean, are you looking at license plates of cars? I suspect you are not.
No. So all of our data is from anonymous GPS probe data, or, you know, think nav units in cars, think some mobile apps. But it's all anonymous. So we get it from a general area. You know, we know it's from a certain zip code maybe, or a census block group or something like that.
For Bob, the bottom line is this.
And what we expect to see is vaccines start to actually go to where people are, as opposed to people going to where the vaccines are.
So are there other applications for this? Well, Pishu says yes, and he suspects some government health officials have been looking at potential super spreader areas like Miami Beach, Florida, and where those cars left from to go to, showing where they could have taken the virus along with them. Live at Lumen Field, the other end of it, Glenn Farley, King 5 News.